videotaping this. We are documenting this historic event. We have some very special music for you. I'd like to let you know that this concert is sponsored by the Performing Visual Arts and Communications Department, which offers a number of degrees for students here at the college. One of them is the Performing Arts degree, where students can study music, dance, theater, and whatever combination interests them. There's also a music performance certificate program that students can enroll in. Our music classes, like the jazz ensemble which you are about to hear, are also open to students of all majors. So we have students who are mechanical engineering, liberal arts, humanities, as well as music performers all in this ensemble. So, with that said, let's hear some music. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
feature Chris LaFaro on the trumpet. Michael Black Cat Smith on the alto saxophone. And James Green on guitar. That was a tune called Critical Mass by Jeff Jarvis. This one came by recommendation of the Black Cat. He said we should play this, and I thought it was a good idea. We're going to go back and go to something of a more classic jazz repertoire by Miles Davis. This is from his Birth of the Cool album called Bopplicity, and it'll feature Alex Papa on the bass, the baritone sax, and Jonathan Mills on the trumpet. Just to give you a little background of something about the people you're hearing, Black Cat Smith is a PFA music major and MPC major. James Green is also a PFA music performance certificate major. Jonathan Mills is a PFA MPC major and has been accepted into the music program at SUNY Fredonia. You'll hear him on this next selection. Next selection is an old jazz standard called Just in Time, and I'm going to welcome welcome to the stage our guest vocalist, Ileana Bernable. Asked Ileana if she would sing this song for us, and she procrastinated a little bit, but she. When did you learn this song?
About this semester, yes.
Just in time for the concert.
Just in
time. Yeah. I know things were a little rough for you at the beginning of the semester.
Yeah, my time was running low.
You know, you got to be careful as a student that you don't burn any of those bridges, and you get those bridges get crossed.
You may not know your way.
True, but you pulled it out. How'd you do it?
I finally found that one love that lovely day.
I think we should sing about that.
I think we should.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
You also heard from Jonathan Mills on that last one. Ileana Burkle, by the way, has been accepted into the acting program at SUNY Purchase. Congratulations. This next piece is entitled Sister Sadie by a jazz pianist and composer named Horace Silver. This will feature on tenor saxophones Emily Venuto and Omar Daniels. Omar Daniels, I should point out, teaches in the community music program here at Dutchess Community College and kindly offered his services to help fill out our saxophone section. You also hear from Mark Coleman, who is a member at large in the community who has been with this ensemble longer than I have. This is my fifth year, so he's a veteran here. So we hope you enjoy this one.
Thank you.
you. That one was turbo powered by our own drummer, Michael Davis. Our last selection this evening is also by student request, Chameleon by Herbie Hancock. We'll have a number of soloists. I'd like to acknowledge them now. Doubling on flute and piano, Amanda Scannell. You will also hear a solo from our alto saxophonist, Mo Jamal. Longtime jazz ensemble contributor, trumpet extraordinaire Joshua Murphy will be taking a solo. Josh was accepted into SUNY Binghamton as a mechanical engineering major. He has promised to design for us a mechanical trombone section. Jimmy Saboteur on trumpet, who is another member of the community who has kindly agreed to join us. And no jazz big band concert would be complete without a battle. So we have a battle of the low basses. Baritone saxophone versus electric bass. Alex Papa versus Teddy Gressler.
Thank you.
Special guests, our own adjunct instructor Helen Avakian has put together an amazing finger guitar style virtuoso extravaganza. So please go on out, take a few minutes to catch your breath. We'll be starting in about 10 minutes with the second half of the program. Thanks so much.
Oh.
I figured, you know, I'm just not going to let this rest. I'm going to bring in some big guns to make sure that this thing, the show still goes on. So Helen Avakian, who's the instructor for the guitar concert, suggested that I bring some of these really fine gentlemen in to perform for you all. So I'd like to introduce Mark Skanga.
Sound question. Brian isn't hooked up to the PA. Did your cord disappear? Oh, your line disappeared. You know, I put it on top of your harp guitar case, but that got moved. Mark's gonna go on a search. Okay. Can you look for that and I'll talk and play? We'll let them find it. Okay. Well, welcome. Thank you, everyone, for coming tonight. Looking forward to this ever since the idea was raised, and we've been sort of talking about this for quite a while, actually over a year. We talked about it on and off, the possibility of bringing in some of my incredible guitar friends from around. Mark and Brian and I have done some touring mostly in the Midwest together, and I'm just really excited to bring what we do here. And so we're gonna do what we do is we're gonna do like a round robin, which is we're each gonna take turns playing a song. Go around a few times, and then that'll be our show. Yeah. And they're figuring it out, so it's distracting me a little bit. So anyway, my name is Helen Avakian, and I teach Guitar Consort and also Music Theory 1 and Oral Skills 1 for the college. And I teach some credit-free classes, some guitar classes, pop styles, classical guitar class, guitar performance ensemble, and private students, and introduction to guitar. And thank you, I see a lot of my students showed up. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you everyone for coming. And anyway, it was great to hear the jazz ensemble. Usually when the concert plays, the concert opens, and then the jazz ensemble plays, but this, you know, so I get to relax after our group plays and watch the jazz ensemble, and this time we have to follow the jazz ensemble, which is a little different, but a good thing. Are we okay? No? What's wrong? We still don't have the... Uh-oh. Do you want some help? Oh, that's what that buzzing is.
Yep. Well, I could see fingers, but I couldn't tell which ones he was holding up.
Okay, we'll track this down. We did come here very early and do a sound check. I promise. So anyway, yes, speaking of the guitar concert, I would love to work with the guitar concert again. So I hope if you're thinking about joining, please join for the fall. We should have a very nice program. In fact, one of the pieces I'm playing tonight, I'm hoping we can play. So you can keep your ears peeled. Let me tell you a little bit about our musicians. So, I'm about to play a song, and I'm going to play it with Terry Champlin, who is an internationally performed guitarist, classical guitar composer. His works have been performed in Greece and Korea and Japan and Europe and Mexico and other places, and he also performs himself a bit. He teaches at Vassar College and Manus College of Music, which is part of the New School now in New York City. And he's going to play with me tonight. You're going to only hear a tiny, tiny piece of what Terry does right now. However, we do have CDs available. And also, Terry and I are going to be performing for the Lunch and Listen concert series at the First Lutheran Church in Poughkeepsie on June 5th. I left flyers on the table in the lobby for you to pick up if you're interested in coming and seeing and hearing more of Terry Champlin with me. And yeah. So we're you want to clap? Go ahead. Let it out. Gee, do I know any jokes? Okay. What do you get when you cross a hiccup and a buttercup. This was told to me by my niece, Burple. Ha ha ha. I always like that joke. It's the only joke I can remember, so. Anyway, so Terry and I are going to start off with a song that one night Terry was quite late from coming home from Vassar, and when he got home, he did something he'd never done. He said, I have to play this song, and a student had come to him with a half-finished song. Terry helped him finish it, changed the whole direction of the song, and then I heard it, and I thought, this is just an amazing song. I absolutely love it. I really just, ever since I heard it, I've been playing it ever since, and I, you know, named my most recent album after it. It's called I Love the Moon, and we will play it, I hope, soon. Are we ready yet? Sounds like I'm in the house. Am I in the house? Do you hear me out there well? Yes? All right. Thank you. Thank you to Doug Like on sound. It's a rough job, and we need you. And he does it great. It was my fault, actually, I think, that problem, perhaps. Okay, I'll take the responsibility. Okay, here we go.
Dark outside, and humbled by no one, and I
much. I now want to present to you Brian Henke. He came out here from Bay Village, Ohio, which is on the shores of Lake Erie, close to Cleveland. And he writes beautiful music, as you'll soon hear. He brought along his harp guitar and his regular guitar. And for those of you who are the guitar students, you'll hear him do some different non-standard tunings. And he has developed his own lot of techniques I've not seen any other guitarist do. He just came up with these things on his own. They're amazing. He's tried to show me how to do them. I didn't practice them enough, I confess, but they are really cool and really hard, but he makes them look really easy. So it's wonderful. And he has a annual woodchopper's ball every year, which raises money for the homeless. And he does something like this. Actually, we got the idea from him. He has like himself and 8 other guitarists perform. So you can get a tiny taste of that here. So Brian Henke, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I'd like to start with a tune from my latest CD, 7 Magic Spells. Now, we all have to admit, today was a really beautiful day, was it not?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, this is a song called It's a Beautiful Day.
Fingerstyle contest, which has been going on since the 1980s, this contest. He came in first. It's not easy to do. Believe me. Well, I wouldn't know. I never came in first. I've watched other people do it. It's not easy. Anyway, he's, well, you'll hear in a second, he's just a master of jazz and popular styles on the nylon string guitar he seems to specialize in. And he knows many, many songs, and he can solo over them. And he plays all around New York City and around the world he tours. So here is Mark Skanga.
Thank you. I'm so delighted to be here and to see that concert, see the jazz band play. Wow, that was close to my heart. I went to college as a jazz major, so I played in bands just like that. So I thought they were really great, very inspiring. I love the idea of young people carrying music forward. When I was a young person, I saw the Beatles on television. And I can remember this, sitting in my pajamas, watching them on the TV, thinking, oh, cool, I want to do that. So right now I'm working on an album at home using this. All Beatles songs, so I'm going to play you one of the arrangements. No one introduced Helen Avakian. The three of us had had the pleasure to perform together a lot. Helen was talking about it. So this is a really comfortable place. I hope I speak for you guys too. We've done a lot. Helen and I usually drive to these crazy places. You know, we're going to Indiana, miles and miles. But I just really want to say how much I admire Ellen's playing and singing and songwriting. It's all so beautiful, and she does it all with this self-effacing kind of style to it. So, ladies and gentlemen, so let's make time for having a back here.
This is called 19 Meets Monaghan's Jig, and I call the first tune 19 because I kind of finished it on August 19th, but I kind of was an excuse. It has a lot of different things I like to do on guitar in it, so. And then the other piece is Pete Hutlinger, who's also quite the fingerstyle player. Actually, he won that contest, the International Fingerstyle Contest, a while ago, and he's just a great player. And so this is his arrangement of a traditional Irish fiddle tune called Monaghan's Jig. And I want to send this out to my guitar students, some of whom have been working on this piece. Thank you.
You guys realize, of course, how lucky you are that she lives in your neighborhood. When I was 17 years old, my little sister Anna was born, the youngest of seven, and I'm the oldest of seven. And I moved away from home at 18, and I would come back to visit, and you know, they used to refer, my little brother used to refer to me as the brother that has long hair like a girl. But I remember I used to, you know, I'd hitchhike in from wherever I was. I was a bit of a tumbleweed back then. And she used to love to sit on my foot and wrap her arms around my knee and have me walk around the house like that. Well, she just passed away about a week ago. And we all knew it was coming. I got to say goodbye to her in December. And she told me she wanted me to play it at her funeral and to play whatever I wanted. I played two songs back to back. I'm going to play one of those for you now. It's a tune that I didn't write, but it's a song that I felt was something that she would have liked to have heard herself do, Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
So it was February of 2001, and I had one of my life's great ambitions fulfilled. I got to go to Brazil. I've always been interested in Brazilian music. One of my early guitar teachers taught me some Antonio Carlos Jobim and those early bossa novas. I remember hearing them on the radio when I was a kid. I always loved them. You know, it's the kind of music that makes you feel like you're in an exotic place with beautiful girls and beaches. It's very good. Anyway, I got to go to Rio. I now have a very good friend there, who I stayed with at that time. And as I was on my way, one of my good friends here in New York said, oh, you're going to Rio in February. You have to go to Carnival. I'm like, well, you know, I don't really dig crowds and crazy scenes. No, no, you have to go. Whatever else you do, you have to go to Carnival. Okay, so we arranged tickets to go to Carnival, which was a small fortune. And it turned out to be the bargain of a lifetime because it was the most amazing experience. 12 hours from 8 at night till 8 the next morning. They've got this giant long street with bleachers on either side of it. They call it the Samba Drome. And the Brazilians, they have Escola de Samba, which is literally a school of samba. And each school of the samba has worked up a song for this year's carnival. There's a theme. They tell you what the theme is ahead of time. So they have these songs written for them. And then they work up these tunes. They make these fabulous costumes. They make floats that make Macy's Day Parade look like kid stuff. And they march down this mile-long street singing and dancing and playing this music, and it's fabulous. And everyone there knows the songs. You know, it's come out on records ahead of time, and they're singing along. It was an unbelievable scene, and it really moved me. So I wrote this song about it from my Skanga Nova album. I call the album Skanga Nova, trying to merge my name with Bossa Nova. You know, I mean, I've only sold 5 of them, so who cares what it's called now? And in the song, if you pay attention, we hear a little story of what I saw during the Samba Parade that blew my mind.
talking afterwards. Terry came back. Okay. I didn't expect you, but hey, thanks for coming back. Yay. Okay, so I guess we're playing Flamenco Town. Okay, so this is a song that we recorded on a CD of guitar duets, and it's a traditional flamenco, except I'm going to play it on a steel string this time because playing with Terry, I've learned, wow, I really like the steel string and the classical and the nylon string together. It's very cool, so I think, anyway. Plus, it's easier to not have to change guitars, honestly. and so, this is a tune I learned. I accompany flamenco dancers at Bard College. I've had this job doing this for 19 years. I cannot hardly believe it. I thought I'd do it for a year or two and kind of landed in it. It was just a big surprise all around. And this teacher that I work for would bring me recordings of flamenco tunes. And I really, you know, I studied, like looked at some books a little bit. I hadn't really studied flamenco, but you know, give it a try. So I listened to the songs and I'd come back. She's like, oh, great, great, okay. So one day she gave me this one. Wow. I loved the piece, but it was a little intimidating. Anyway, here it is. Hope you enjoy it. It's called Zambra, and it's kind of got a Middle Eastern flavor to it as well. Thank you.
Now, a lot of you have probably taken pictures of this. Would you like to hear the true story about how this was built, how this came about? Well, I'll tell this other one instead. My luthier is from Madison, Ohio, was out in L.A. in Hollywood during the filming of a movie. And he had with him two guitars and a harp. And he's on this movie set, and he wanted to put them someplace safe, because you know how unsavory these movie people are. Almost as bad as musicians. So he put them in the closet to keep them safe. Unfortunately, he was on the movie set of the movie The Fly. And that wasn't a closet that he put him into. It was that machine that turned poor Jeb into The Fly. He went back to get him, and they refused to get her like this.